Sacred Insights 101, ready to do your reading for August. The very first card that we get is from Kuan Yin, with care and compassion. Now what the card says is choose to be loved, do what is right for everyone involved, offer a helping hand. This card is saying, okay, this is who you are. This is fundamental to the reading because it's basically saying, this is who you are. You already do this. You choose love all the time. You offer helping hands all the time. You love those win-wins. That's what I kept hearing when I tapped into you guys. It's like the win-wins, wanting to sort of take care and compassion for everyone. Excuse me. The next card that comes up. And so, you know, right, her energy is just very gentle. It's very sweet. She's surrounded by flowers, and it's just very care and compassion for everyone, right? The next card that comes up is Commander Ashtar. Commander Ashtar comes in and says, okay, call to action now. There's a call to action now. So both of these are like first cards from the Keepers of the Light deck going together. It's like this is who you are sort of fundamentally, and now it's time to take action. There's a call to take action. It's time to let go of any stress. And what this card is saying is that is speaking to not taking on the stress of other people. Breathe it out right now. And what they're saying is that while you spend a lot of time, maybe a lot of time, focusing on the win-wins and trying to sort of accommodate, offer a helping hand, be loving, they're saying to just sort of reel that in. Like, it's okay to have compassion, but then let it go. It's not yours. It's not whatever the situation is for the other that's calling for compassion and love. It is not your situation to take on. And so some Pisces might tend to do that. And so they're speaking to that aspect of where you're offering compassion and love. The action that Commander Ashtar is wanting you to take is to get back into your own self, letting go of what's not yours, kind of on a regular basis, sort of letting that become who, letting that also become who you are, right? As these two are coming together, it's like, this is who you are, let this be who you are too, because it is. And one way that can really help really embody that commander is to breathe out the stress that's not yours on a regular basis. It's about claiming your independence. It's about being independent while you have compassion for people and offer a helping hand everywhere you can. And those win-wins are fabulous. I love those too. I love them. But there's a level of maintaining your independence in doing that. Prioritizing yourself first. Being the commander of your own life. Kind of thing. Claiming your independence. The next card that wants to come up is the career transition from Shamuel, and he wants to call back. It's a call to action. Your reading very much feels like it's about career. It's all about career. Some of the other signs are getting both love and relationship, relationship and career. For Pisces, it's very much about independence and career. And so Shamuel is saying that your life purpose is triggering a blessed career change, transition. It could be, for some of you, it could be a completely radical different thing. Just sort of taking a moment, claiming your independence and going, okay, you know, is this career that I have now really working for me? And finding something else that's better for you, better suited to you and who you are now. And for others of you, you might sort of be on track, but there might be just some little things that aren't quite, you know, it's just not completely quite lined up. So Well, he's saying career transition. It could be radical for some of you. For others, it's just tweaking. You know, it's just about tweaking little things about it to make it that much more lined up. And we say that because it's like the Haniel comes in and says that there's an opportunity here to improve your plans, as if you already have the plans, but now you have an opportunity to just sort of tweak it, just improve it a little bit. Listen to your intuition about this for some accurate guidance. Face your fears and grow stronger. So these little things that you might want to tweak could be fears around being seen, being heard, maybe doing something, trying something you've never done before. It could be working with others where you're used to working on your own. Any aspect of a career where it feels like it's just kind of off a little bit, there's a reason that it feels off, and that's because it's calling for you to face a fear of some kind. Face a fear and grow stronger. So these little tweaks, it feels like they're little, but they're not. They're huge. It feels like little, like the feeling overall is it's just not quite right. But the reason it's not quite right is something sort of profound in you that's calling for healing. And when this healing happens, you'll just get this click, you know, and it'll just line up. Here's another card that's kind of saying the same thing. There's a better way to do this thing that feels like it's off just a little bit. There's a better way to do it. So these two kind of come together. You have an opportunity to improve on your plans because there's just a better way to do a little something. Pause for reflection and insight, and dare to be different. Notice this angel's upside down. I know these cards are really dark. I'm sorry. They are what they are. They're very dark. But this in color, not energy, in color. I love this deck, by the way. But they are kind of dark in color. But this angel is upside down. He's being different. Right, so dare to be a little bit different. That could be what's causing you to feel like it's just not quite lined up because maybe it's something that hasn't been done before, or it just feels like you're not sure if people will be on board with you with this new creative idea. But Pisces, you guys think outside the box on a regular basis, thinking outside the box. So dare to be different. It's okay to be different. Our times are calling for different. So there's, you know, if there's a little bit better way, a little bit better way to tweak something, just face those fears and see if you can grow stronger. Follow your guidance, your intuition, and step through that fear and go for it. As you're looking for what might tweak, you know, what sort of activity or thing that you'd like to do in your business or this other job that you might like to have, the energy of August is very, very fast. It's very just like very fast. And so the very next card that wants to go is, you found it. Oh, there's a challenge. I want to tweak something. Okay, face the fear, step through it. There we go. And we found it. It's like that. It's like that. So I've experienced this myself, so I know it's possible. It's making me smile so big because this has been happening for me lately. So face your fear and step through it, because you can. When he's saying you found it, you're not only finding the tweak, but you're also finding that independence where you face your fear and you step through it, and you just become just that little tweak, just much more like this. Does that make sense? You're still this. You're always going to be this. That's who you are. Always going to be that. But it gives you a little bit more of this. A little bit more feeling of this. And there's two of these. So they're saying that, okay, so they want to come back to say, you know, there's two cards that are kind of saying the same thing. That, you know, things could be a little bit different. You have an opportunity for a little bit of a change, and things could be slightly different. You know, there's two cards. So In other words, this may happen for you more than once. There may be more than one kind of fear that you get to get the opportunity to sort of step through. You guys, I'm encouraging you to step through it. It's exciting. And then you heal. You found it. In other words, you found the wound. Okay? So he's saying you're going to find some wounds and you're going to get to heal them and get a little bit closer to this and a little bit closer to this. Each time. It's very, very exciting. This change is coming. It's like a shift from, notice the colors in this one, they're kind of dark colors, and then we get this positive change. So two cards talking about change. Actually, three cards talking about change. Hello to the new powerful you, and goodbye to those fearful aspects of you, kind of thing. And this one also says this change is going to make things so much better. These changes are going to make things so much better for you, but also for everyone else, as you create your win-wins kind of thing. Yeah, so change is also with these colors and activity here. They want these three to be held up together so that you can see sort of the sequence. It's like this change over here coming out of fear, right? Coming out of a little bit of darkness to lots and lots of color for yourself, to having it change your life experience along with everyone else that you come in contact with. And like this change is just affects, it affects you and everyone else. It's wonderful. It's very, very exciting. So then as these tweaks happen, it's like it could be that your project expands. It could be some things get let go of that create this click. Maybe you drop something that doesn't serve you anymore. Click, right? Maybe you add something that is more in line with who you are that you would just love, you know, click. And so this could involve lots of things. So Metatron is coming in to say, you know, I'm going to help you prioritize your project at this point to really honor the things that you really love doing and to let go of the things you don't. And take the things that are left that you really, really love and help prioritize them. Sort of organize what it is that you're going to do next as you go. The next card that we get is steady progress. It's like one step at a time, one step at a time. And there will be steady progress. Yep, very exciting. And then with that, we get all these positive new experiences. The Ace of Raphael, who is the healer, right? Positive new emotional experiences, fulfilling relationships, deep and lasting spiritual insights, deep and lasting spiritual insights. This is referring to this fear that you're going to be stepping through deep and lasting changes, deep and lasting changes for you as you step through these little fears, these little things that come up for you. And it feels like for other readings, it's been it has looked like in real life challenges in relationships or challenges between people at work kind of thing. For you guys, it's about you and what you're wanting to create in your career and feeling somewhat stifled and not quite right in creating what you want to create. That's where your sort of glitch is happening. And it gets cleared up like that. Things are just like really fast. See, there's the airplane. Really, really fast. Deep and lasting insights and fulfilling and rewarding and the flow of prosperity happening for you. And your final card is that dreams come true. This genie comes in, Raphael again, the healer. Make a wish. Dreams become reality. This is a very joyful time of life for you. Very joyful time. So, like deep insights, a flow of prosperity, wishes and dreams fulfilled, wishes coming true. All of this, as this career path that you're on as in an independent, caring, loving, passionate, beautiful commander, right? And as you step through the fear, oh, this great stuff, all this great stuff can happen. And it's like this, it's like really, really fast. So look for the guidance from spirit. Listen to your intuition and follow your guidance. You guys will be good to go. This is really all good. And even the fears that come up feel very, very doable, even though they're deep. It's a really interesting energy this month. It's like even though the wounds are deep, it feels quick and relatively easy to have them heal. And it really only takes a moment. You know, sometimes we think things are just gonna, that when things are big emotionally, they can feel like they'll take a long time. They can go really fast and they can be much easier than you think. So go for it, Pisces. I love you guys so much. Until next time, take really good care of yourselves, and I'll talk to you soon. Mwah.